Hello class 7, a very good morning to all of you. I am going to explain chapter number 2, The Tiger, which is written by William Blake. The poem has been divided in 6 stanzas having 4 lines each. In the first stanza, the poet says that the tiger is burning bright in the forest of the night. The line means that the tiger which is in the forest is burning like fire, or in other words, looking like yellow fire in the dead of night. The burning bright also reflects the tiger bright yellow color that makes it look fierce. In the third line, the poet raises a rhetorical question, which is the immortal hand or eye, which is capable of framing or building its fearful symmetry. The poet, in a way, appreciating the power of God who can create such a fearful structure and bear its appearance. The man can neither create it or can bear its appearance due to fear. In the next stanza, the poet talks about the eyes of the tiger. He wonders from which distant the fire has been brought and put into the eyes of the tiger. The fire has been brought either from skies, either sun or heaven, or from deep ocean, means either core of the earth or hell. Because it cannot be an ordinary fire of the world, but divine one, which makes the eyes of the tiger so fierce. In the third line, the poet wonders which were those wings that took him to those distant areas. Similarly, which were the hands which dared to catch the divine fire. So in the first two lines, he appreciates the fire, and in the third and fourth line, he appreciates the wings and hands of the creator. The creator is God. Stanza third. In the third stanza, the poet talks about the heart of the tiger. He too have heart also. He wonders what kind of shoulders and the art the creator would have, which twist that means giving a shape. The muscles or ligaments of tiger's heart. Here the poet is praising the power and amazing art of God, which helped him creating tiger's heart. In the third line, he is amazed by thinking how powerful creator's hand and feet are, which made him stand in front of the tiger when its heart began to beat. In this stanza, the poet seems to praise the creator's physical power, daring nature, and his jaw-dropping art. In the fourth stanza, the poet praises the brain of the tiger. He wonders which hammer, chain, anvil, and furnace the creator would have used to create the brain of the tiger. These tools are used by the ironsmith to create solid and heavy items. Ironsmith, you people all know who is ironsmith. That is Luhar. The brain of the tiger for the poet is no less than iron. Hence he thinks about the divine tool used to create the brain of such a deadly animal. Again, the poet wonders how powerful would the grasp of the creator which could hold the deadly brain of this animal. In the fifth stanza, the poet tends to compare this deadly animal to the lamb, which is meek, innocent, and quite opposite to the former. In addition, there is also a reference to a biblical incident as mentioned in. The poet says that when God created the tiger, the star, Here means Satan and his follower, which were in war with him, were so frightened by its sight, tiger's sight, that they accepted their defeat and threw down their weapon and made the sky wet with their tears. In the third line, the poet wonders, would God have smiled after creating tiger, as it was beyond words for satanic forces? He again thinks, is he the same who created the lamb, because the latter is quite innocent and meek, while the former is deadly enough to frighten Satan. The final stanza, that is sixth stanza, is a repetition of the first one. The only word changing here is dare, instead of would. Could, which is quite significant in the first stanza, the poet seems to be less amazed by the power of tiger and God. But after doing through all the features of the tiger, he wonders, it is only God who can dare to create such an animal. Thank you very much, class 7. Hope you all understand this poem. Please try to learn the summary. That is already given in your notes.